show me the money. That's kind of what Gary Gensler, the chairman of the Commodity Futures Trading Commission, appears to be telling Congress as he meets various committee members this week in Washington. So we're going to talk a little bit about that. Hi, my name is Greg Crawford. I'm the editor of TAB Forum, joined today by Larry Tabb, founder and CEO of TAB Group. Larry, good to see you.
Great to be here, Greg.
So as I mentioned, Larry, Gary Gensler, the CFTC chief, is testifying in front of Congress, pointing out that he's operating under a $169 million budget, which was the fiscal 2010 number. He's asked for $261 million for fiscal 2011, which we're currently in, and then another, he's asked for $308 million for fiscal 2012. At the same time, you've got Commissioner Scott O'Malley, who we know well here at TAB Group, has said that he doesn't agree with the budget request of the $308 million, but not so much the number, but the fact that there's no apparent strategy behind it. So there's, and then we've got the Republican lawmakers who are sort of raising this balloon that they may keep funding tight to sort of limit the regulator's ability to implement Dodd-Frank. A lot of moving parts here, Larry. What's your take on the whole budget issue that the CFTC is facing? It's clearly serious.
Absolutely serious. And I think that the issue is, you know, purely political. And then, you know, but on the other hand, there needs to be a real thought and strategy around this budget. And I kind of align more with O'Malley than Gensler in that, you know, the issue is that the CFTC is now taking on almost double, if not more than double, their regulatory effort.
Right.
You know, if you look at the CFTC or the SEC, the SEC's budget's over $1 billion, and here's CFTC's budget, you know, at best is $300 million.
Right.
So it's you know, a quarter really of what the SEC has. The issue really needs to be is that we need to rethink, you know, people versus technology infrastructure. And I think that what we're looking at, especially if we want to see greater transparency, greater reporting, greater amount of data, greater centralization of risk, greater analytics on risk, that's not going to be done with people and spreadsheets. That's going to be done with, you know, modeling infrastructure and technology,
right,
and servers and data and analysis engines. And I think, you know, just the whole desire just to go and hire, you know, X hundred more people, it's like throwing guys with green eye shades, you know, into a high-frequency trading shop. It's
right.
Just, you know, it doesn't really mix. Now, so they're going to need some people, and they're going to need some technologists to
right.
kind of put this together, but I would much rather see a greater technology effort thrown in here to try to leverage those people better than just, you know, here, take a bunch of people and go figure it out.
Find an office and, set up. So you've got O'Malley out there who's pushing this idea of technology. And when he was at our conference a few weeks ago, he talked about the importance of technology, not only just to on the surveillance side of things, but also just becoming a more efficient regulator.
Right.
How do you think how much success will he have, you know, delivering that message? I mean, do you think he'll have any, because clearly Gensler seems to be, he always talks about how many people they have to hire and that sort of thing, but, you know, how do you think, how much voice do you think O'Malley will have in terms of pushing that side of the agenda?
Good question. Don't know. But that said, you know, O'Malley, at our forum a couple of weeks ago, he was the guy that first raised this flag and basically
right.
said, you know, hey, they're cutting our technology budget. We're going to run out of storage in October.
Right. Yeah.
So you know, and now all of a sudden you're seeing a larger budget. Gensler was saying, okay, hey, I can live within the budget. You know, it's like, you know, not to disparage, you know, Commissioner Gensler,
right.
but or Chairman Gensler, but. You know, one day he says, "Oh, well, I can make do," and the next day he says, "I want $300 million."
Yeah.
This is sounding pretty like, you know, whichever way the wind blows.
Right.
And so I would rather see a much more strong technology initiative, a really aligned set of plans, a really aligned, you know, strategic direction.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to see it go the way the SEC does. Oh, let me go, you know, buy a gazillion amount of, you know, square feet of real estate. Oh, we don't need it.
Yeah.
Oh, it was outside the procurement. You know, it's like they're gonna if they don't have a strong plan, a strong technology view, a strong group of senior level technologists driving this, they're going to wind up the laughing stock, and they're going to create a bigger problem than you actually need.
And they'll fall behind the marketplace as well.
Absolutely.
Which is a perennial problem. So you know, your first point, Larry, was you know, about this sort of being a political issue over the money, and it's clear we see that across many areas of government today. But what's the upshot for, you know, TAB Forum members? If you're a market player, an exchange, you're trying to do business in this field, you're working in the OTC market, And yet you've got this political football being bounced around in Washington. I mean, are you sort of hamstrung until they iron this out? Well,
I think certainly you are hamstrung, you know, for certain some of the macro issues. And to some of the macro issues, they actually need lawyers to write rules.
Yeah.
So for that standpoint, they actually need some people. But once they get done with that, then it's more technology.
Okay.
But once we define, you know, what are the SAFs, how do they work, how does clearing work,
right,
how does all this interoperate, then we can start, the firms can start figuring this out. Certainly, I think the ground rules are not all developed yet. And
right,
I think we need to see the rules written first. That said, I think there are certain things you can plan for. You know, data management is going to be very critical. The ability to think about, you know, clearing, so get all your transactions in order to figure out how to align your databases and be able to liberate and move that data. Certainly, getting things out to the information warehouse or different information repositories. There are things you can get moving in the right direction, but until some of the products are created, until
right,
we know the format of the clearing mechanisms.
Yep.
It's going to be hard to write code to the specifics that don't exist.
Okay, very good. Well, we'll leave it there. A lot to keep our eyes on as Washington debates the dollars behind funding a key regulator for Wall Street and certainly for a lot of Tab Forum members. So keep your eyes peeled here. Again, my name is Greg Crawford. I'm the editor of Tab Forum, joined by Larry Tab, founder and CEO of Tab Group. Thanks for joining us.